Hi dear friends, welcome to Top Education. In this session we will learn MSM, Marketing and Service Management, full chapter. So let's begin with it. Here are few conditions of mind. While teaching, you have to close down your eyes and then you will imagine what I am teaching. If not, it will be too rubbish for you. So please close down your eyes and hear this voice. And if you do this, you will understand the whole concept particularly. So please, it's a request. Okay, let's begin with our chapter. First chapter, that is Introduction to Marketing. Now, Introduction to Marketing means like we are introducing a market. Introduction, yes, what is market, how it will help, what are the types of market, what are the types of marketing mix, what are the recent trends in marketing. So all about marketing, we are learning all about the marketing in this chapter. So first let's begin with like meaning of market. Now, meaning of market means market is a place where buying and selling take place. Yes. So what is market? Market is a place where buying and selling take place. For and we have a definition also. So what is the definition? Let's know. Total demand of potential buyer for a product or service. So the total demand of a potential of that particular buyer for a product or service is known as market. Now let's know what is marketing. That was market. Now we are learning is marketing. Now what is marketing means? Marketing involves all those activities which results in flow of goods and services from the producer to consumer. Now marketing means like producing a product somewhere else and giving the product to the consumer, that between the transportation is called marketing. So marketing involves all those activities which results in flow of goods and services from producer to consumer. Next, here also we have a definition of marketing. So what is marketing definition is? Marketing is a business process through which the product flows, yes. So what is market? Now, marketing is a business process. All we know, it's a business process through which the products are matched. Now, the marketing will match the products with the needs of the consumer, and the transfer of ownership is affected. Yes, we know if marketing is done, then the transfer of ownership is affected. Yes, it is normally. So here marketing is a business process through which the products are matched with the needs of the consumers and the ownership is affected. So this is a definition. So according to me, when we write a definition, we have to quote it out. Okay, so double comma for up. Okay, so that will show your impression of your paper. So next we'll go to the Now advantages of marketing. A small child can say what are the advantages and disadvantages of marketing. It's your own, write in your own. Okay, so it's not too hard also. I can give an example of advantages of marketing. Marketing helps to know the consumer about the product. Marketing helps to grow the brand name of the product. Marketing helps many times. Marketing increases the sales. Marketing increases the profit. This is all the advantages. Disadvantages also are there. Marketing, lack of what? We can write like lack of coordination between them. lack of quality, quantity of the product, lack of fixing the price, ability to fix the price, that is not proper. So advantages and disadvantages, a small child can write down, it's easy to do. Okay, so next is goals of marketing. Here goals of marketing is also so easier, it's not too hard at all. Okay, first point is to satisfy customers, to increase profit for growth of business, to create customer base for business, to determine marketing mix that will satisfy the needs of the customers, to create good image. This and all, what you have to do is, first the heading you should know. If you know the heading, then inside you can fill your own, not like stories and all, but related to it. Like for example, to satisfy customers. Yes, here what we can write, to satisfy customers. Understand? Yes, to satisfy customers. The heading is this. Under that you will write this, all the manager together, all the department, different departments of manager together, join their hands for the customer satisfaction. This is a marketing. Yes, you can write this also. It's too easy. Don't leave your page empty. First of all, you should fill it up with a common sense. Okay, next we'll go to the concept of marketing. It's also too easy. So there are traditional concept of marketing and modern concept. Traditional means the olden days and modern means which are going now. So for example, we'll learn in detail only traditional concept of marketing. So traditional means selling, modern means marketing. Understand these two points, you will be able to find it out. Product oriented philosophy. Yes, A, product oriented philosophy. Here till 1930, first you understand what is there in that para, then what you get to know, then you write it on a page, then you will understand. Okay, so till 1930 there was a strong feeling that when a firm produces good product, it results in automatic consumer response without any promotional efforts. That is, product is really good and price is reasonable, there is no need of special marketing efforts. Easy. So if the quality and quantity of the product and the price is reasonable, then there is no need of any any marketing techniques. That is written in this philosophy. You just note it down, 1930. It will be easy. So a good product is equal to good sales. Yes, good quality, good quantity, good price is equal to good sales. Sales oriented philosophy. The failure of production oriented philosophy paved the way for sales oriented philosophy in 1940. That was 1930. This is 1940. According to this philosophy, making available of best product is not enough. Okay, making of best product is not enough. Promotional activity should be given. Every nook and corner, every person should know that there is a product which satisfies them. So product plus promotion is equal to sales. Customer oriented philosophy. In this philosophy, 1950 1930 1940 1950, if you write this 1950 1930, the marks can be earned as more. Okay, this is a point where I understand. So what is customer oriented philosophy means, in 1950 there was a customer, like sales oriented also failed. So customer means what is the need of the customer, they have to produce that one, then only the customer will purchase. So this oriented philosophy also came into existence. And then we have social oriented philosophy. Social oriented philosophy means it came in 1970s and 1980s. According to this concept, the firm should understand the customer needs, should also think of the customers and social welfare. So here the customer should know the social welfare also, not a customer, the manufacturer also should know the, about social welfare also. So here social welfare is also added. Guys, these formulas are too easy. You have to just plus 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 equals equal to good sales, plus 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 good sales plus social welfare. That's it. It's not too hard. And next we have is modern concept. Modern concept means here we have marketing. There also we had marketing, but it's not thus. Here they have gave. So modern concept means remarketing concept. What is remarketing concept means? We have a cotton. When we prepare a cotton sweater, that is known as remarketing. Cotton is a good. We are using it as, it is a raw material. So it is remarketing concept. Demarketing concept. For example, I can give you cigarette. On the cigarette packet, they have written harm. Dangerous to drink cigarette. But people drink. So this is a demarketing concept. Over marketing means like neglecting quality standards and direct all the resources in increasing sales. Now over marketing means they will not decide, they will not they will not have a concept on quality or quantity. They want only good sales. So this is called over marketing. Green or eco marketing. Example, newspaper bags, using paper bags, etc. Event marketing. For example, Vivo is giving IPL, Pepsi was giving IPL, and more. Speed marketing. Today everyone is thinking in the term of making money or having position. Today one is going to succeed when he meet the requirements of consumers and time. It helps in making innovation in industry. For speed marketing means when the consumer needs that product should be ready for the customer. They should produce at that time only. So this is speed marketing. All the consumer will satisfy by that. Okay. One-to-one marketing, providing product based on the consumer needs and not to the customer to adjust to the product. Here also one-to-one marketing means a direct contact is made between the customer and the manufacturer. The customer demands for the products and the manufacturer manufactures the product for that type of customer. For example, eyeglasses. Every lens has different. So one-to-one. This is a good example. Okay. Now next we have difference between traditional modern. That is too easy. Then we have scope of marketing. So who are involved in marketing? First goods, then services, events, persons, organizations, and etc. So scope of marketing is also an easy topic to cover. It's just for 2 minutes, you can do it. Approaches of marketing. Yeah, this is little bit lengthy, so let's do approaches of marketing. Commodity approach. Under this approach, we study the flow of commodity from producer to consumer. It refers to a detailed study of the problems encountered in the process of marketing a particular product, like financial problem, transportation problem, storage problem, etc. Commodity approach. Commodity approach means here you can understand like what the consumer wants, what the customer wants, we have to do that. The manufacturer have to do that, then it is commodity approach. Institutional approach. Under this approach, our main interest
center around the marketing institutions or agencies such as wholesalers, retailers, banks, insurance, transport, undertaking companies, etc., who participates in discharging their marketing responsibilities during the movement of distribution of goods. So institution includes banking system, financial system, or the institution which is related to the marketing. They all are involved for the distribution of goods. Functional approach. Yes, in this approach we concerned on specialized functions or services or activity performed by marketers such as buying, selling, storing, transporting. Functional approach means what they are doing, like they are storing, that is a function. They are selling, they are transporting the goods, this is also a functional approach. Next we have is decision making. Decision making means this approach studies the decision making process by the management to maximize the profit of the firm. So you got to know like why this decision making means they will decide like what quality they have to produce, what type of product they have to produce, like what they have to fix, how they have to fix the price and many things, etc. Okay, then next we have is system approach. Now system approach means it is an integral part, means it is an internal part bringing all marketing activities under an integrated whole. According to marketing system can effectively perform when all other subsystems like channel of distribution, packing, advertising, transportation, etc. are effective. So system approach means all they have to gather. Yes, like only advertisement cannot do everything. There should be a proper supply also for supply, transportation, advertisement, sales promotion and prices, and the quality of the product should be good, then only the product will be reached on the top. Then legal approach focuses on attention of legal transfer of ownership of goods to the buyer. It highlights the various legislations that are enforced to support marketing, like Sales of Goods Act, Marriage Act, etc. Here legal approaches means they have to legally sell all their products. There should not be an illegal product in that company. If it's, the company will shut down, or this is and not a marketing process at all. There should be a proper product and a proper marketing also should be done. Social approach. Society identifies the consumption needs and satisfies it. They project their desires, products, producer products accordingly and sell to the consumer. Social approach means here the consumer have their own social, like many people use Mysore sandal soap till now because social, like they have connected to that Mysore sandal soap, so they are using. So this is a good example for the social approach. So the Mysore sandal soap company, they produces this types of soaps only to satisfy their consumer, and it is going on also. Economic approach considers market forces like demand, price, etc. Now economic means economic, which includes prices, demand for the good, supply for the good, etc. So this is all done in economic functions. Now let's do another topic, which is functions of marketing. I think it can be an important question, but don't believe this questions. Okay, MSM can create anything, so we have to learn full syllabus only. So functions of exchange refers to the transfer of goods and services for the value. Yeah, easy. Then buying function, selling function. Buying means in business one has to buy the produce products that are needed by the consumers. Buying goods refers to buying right goods at right time, right place, etc. Selling function. So here In functions of exchange, we have two types of functions like buying function and selling function. Now, selling function, it involves transfer of title of goods to the buyer for a profit. So, the transfer of title, now producer goes to consumer. Now, consumer is owner because he have paid some amount for the product. So, selling function, buying function, they are so easy. Now, next we have is functions of physical supply. Functions of physical supply means like ultimate tech, like it should reach that type of who need that consumer, for them only that product should be reached. For example, assembling function, all the goods should be assembled at the place and then dispatches also together. Then transportation, the transportation should be taken like smoothly, the products should not be damaged while transportation. Storing and warehousing. The main point here, why we do storing and warehousing, is when there is no demand, we store the goods. We warehouse the goods. When the demand increases, we remove that old, like that they are new goods only, they are not used, that goods, and we sell when the demand is created in the market. So this is warehousing. Then next we have facilitating functions. Here we have financing. We have to finance, like we have to acquire land, labor and all, and we have to take finances from the companies also, like short term, medium term, etc. Risk bearing means here insurance, it is talking about insurance. We have to take insurance of the company, not company, but what type of goods are produced. Like in olden days, many agarbatti factories were burning because of some problems and all the loss were done. But nowadays, the agarbatti factories are doing insurance. So if the agarbatti is burning, they will get insurance also. So the half of the amount comes to them, or the full amount, as an insurance. So it is a not loss. So while starting a business, we have to make sure to insure our company or take an insurance. Standardization and grading. Standardization and grading means we have to produce the standard type of products. Yes, and grading, give a grade to your product. First grade, second grade, third grade. This is all a marketing techniques. Marketing information, it includes facts relating to the market in collecting information. What is demand? What they have to produce? Competition, quality, etc. So here everything is decided. So what they have to produce, they will produce. They will not produce any other products. So marketing information. Information means like they will produce, they will take an information like yes, consumer, what you want, he will say a Coke, then they will produce a Coke. Not this is a so silly example. For big products like a car, Mercedes cars, they want some futures in it. So this all are marketing information will also helps. And then another topic we have is recent trends in marketing. So today in marketing, many changes came, many changes went, and many changes are there till now. So let's know about e-business. What is e-business means? Electronic business. It means buying and selling of goods through online, Amazon. The best example I can say is Amazon, because that is the one who is earning crores together today in present. Somebody are not seeing the news, but they have to see news. That is good. Okay, so Amazon is earning crores together. So this is e-business. Advantages and disadvantages can be given by you people. So what, like you can create a debate also while writing your question paper. So yeah, these are advantages, these are disadvantages. There is no, okay, you can do everything. Okay, so next we have different types of models of e-business. Okay, so this is also so easy. B2B, B2C, B2G, G2C, C2B. Like business to consumer, consumer to business, consumer to consumer, business to government, business to business. Like example for C2C, nobody have that C2C example, all ask this questions. So C2C we can have OLX, yes, quicker, quicker and OLX. These are the best example to C2C, customer and customer only. The old goods are sold to the next customer. Then we have M business refers to mobile business means not using mobile. Here SMS and MMS is used. Like SMS means short message service and MMS means multimedia service. So these are all used. And then we have telemarketing means here the phone is used. Next is telemarketing means here mobile is a telephone is used, but this type of what they say marketing now it's not working, so it's okay. Telemarketing, you can give advantages and disadvantages. Oh my god, here everyone are certain to give advantages and disadvantages of thing. First you should know what is that thing. Now I have said you that is a telephone marketing. Now it is not used. You can give example and like advantages and disadvantages. No problem. Relationship marketing means here a good relationship is created. The marketing people will create a good close relationship with the consumer. Okay, consumer who consumes the goods. So they'll sell all their goods to that consumer only by saying him, this is good, this is that, this is those, everything they will say, and they'll sell their goods. Retailing, I think every person knows what is retailing. If they don't know, then they are hero. Yes. Okay, retailing means the whole. They buy the products in a lump sum amount and they sell the product in single quantity is known as retailing. Here profit is earned as minimum, as not too much profit is earned. Oh, yes, okay, you can give this also. Okay, examples or advantages and disadvantages also. Then we have virtual marketing. Virtual marketing means here we'll have without any face-to-face contact. Okay, so here doorstep, like Amazon only. Virtual marketing means Amazon only, I think. Yes, here they have written like door to door step. They will go and give their products delivery. They will book their product on online and some person will come and give. So this is a type of this only. The network marketing means here a browser is used for network or multi-level marketing. Green marketing, my god, yeah, everyone knows here green marketing, using all those goods which are waste, like plastic bottles can be used as home decorator, newspaper can be used as paper bag. Yes, this and all we can use. And we have last topic but not least topic, that is customer relationship management. Okay, customer relationship management. Now what is customer relationship management means? It is a business strategy identified towards understanding, integrating. Means here we will understand the relationship. Here we will understand everything of the consumer. We'll know their advantages, we'll know their disadvantages, we'll know their income level, we'll know their standards, we'll know everything about that consumer. So this is known as customer relationship management. Means here a data is kept. Data means I have said you what is data, okay? So this all are maintained here, and that's it. In this chapter, you can write this much only. Yes, so it's too big session. Yeah, I'm also, my throat is also paining. So goodbye and have a good future. So one thought I can say you in last is, nothing it is good, okay, it is good that not having, there should be anything. See, while you write in your paper, write fully, don't leave it empty. This is my request to you all guys, please write, not stories, but yeah, don't write something stories. I have said, oh, fill your paper so you will write your stories. No, write relatedly, you will get some marks at least. They'll think that, yeah, the student have written something related to it. You can earn marks. Yes. See, this is 21st century. Here, what we have read in textbook, we will not write the same. Okay. Don't think the topper who will get 99.99, he is also not writing the same points which are in textbooks, which are given by a teacher. He will create his own think. He will understand. Many people have the habit of ratamar. Ratamar, it's not okay, but many people try, and they will face problems in last exam times by ratamaring all the syllabus. So it's better to understand now. Start studying. There is only a 1 month left. So be started to it. And my videos will be created more and more. Okay. Thank you for watching Top Education. Thank you. Like, share, subscribe. Thank you.